Hello everybody and welcome to my video for the presentation of Wiley Solution Walkthrough. This is Accounting Tools for Business Decision Making, 8th edition. This is exercises 13-3, 13-4, and 13-5. This is Accounting Tools for Business Decision Making, 8th edition. Authors are Paul Kimmel, Jerry Weingant, and Jill Mitchell. The question used in the presentation, and I got to change it now, it's 2023, copyright John Wiley by John Wiley and Sons. Just give me a moment and I will change that right over here as we're ushering in a new year. Okay, so like magic, we have gone through and changed the main PowerPoint slide. So it's pretty exciting. All rights are reserved. This is for educational purposes only. The video may not be distributed or redistributed without the express permission of Wiley. The solution presentation is copyright 2023 by Bennett Tchaikovsky. All rights are reserved. The opinions contained within this presentation are of myself and not the authors of the textbook of Wiley. And I want to give Wiley a shout out for allowing me to use this, to use her text for making these videos. I think it's very beneficial to students and I wish other publishers would feel the same way, but it's not the case. Okay. So right over here, I'm going to kind of do all these exercises at once just because they're relatively straightforward. The first one over here is talking about a horizontal analysis. So when we think of horizontal, right, just kind of think about it like you're laying on your back horizontally. When we think of vertical analysis, we're going through and thinking of it as being up and down, right? So vertical, and this would be horizontal. Okay, now what does this mean? Well, when we have a vertical financial analysis, it means another word of saying is what I like to call my common sized financial statement. So I'm showing everything as a percentage. But when we are going through and looking at horizontal analysis, what we're going to go through and do is basically come up with a base year. In this case, right over here, our base year is going to be the first year or December 31st, 2024. So when we look at a horizontal analysis, right, and it tells us to use 2024 as a base year, what I'm going to do is I'm basically going to compare, say, okay, my current assets in 2024 were 90,000, they're now 106. So the change is going to be 106 minus 90. Okay, so this is 106 minus 90 or 16,000. So this increase in my total current assets right now, when I'm doing a horizontal, so when I do a horizontal analysis, I want to come up with the change first, then I'm going to show the increase, the percentage increase or decrease. So in this case here, I'm going to take the change and I'm going to divide it into the base year or the 2024 of the item that I'm going through and doing. So this is an increase of 17.78% of current assets or for current assets. That's all we're going through and doing when we have a vertical analysis, excuse me, a horizontal analysis. If we do the same thing here, my plant assets increased by 50,000 or 400 minus 350. So what increases this, it's going to be 50,000 divided by 350. My plant assets increased by 14.29%. Okay, let's do the same thing over here. My current liabilities also increased by 34,000. Okay, so this is going to be, I take the amount of the change and I divide it by the base year, right? So this is over here, this is a 52%, an increase of 52.31% for current liabilities. Okay, I'm not going to put this on any one of my exams if you're in my class, but the reason why I'm spending the time to go over this right now is when we take, when we study certain subjects later on, you're going to go through and see how this comes about. And again, where did I get the 17.78%? It's going to be 16,000. divided by 90, which is the base year, is 17.78%. The 50,000 divided by the 350 is equal to 14.29%. The 34 divided by the 65 is going to be equal to 52.31%. Over here, my long-term liabilities increase by 32,000 or 122 minus 90. So when I take the 32 divided by 90, I'm going to get over here. Is 35.56%. For long-term liabilities. And just so you know, this is really not the way you should say it. It should be non-current liabilities. Okay. And that's more of a legal term, why you don't want to call it long-term. Okay. Over here for the common stock at par, this again, you're showing an increase of 15,000 or 130 minus 115. When I take that 15,000, I compare it to the base year, or 15 divided by 115, I'm going to get approximately 13%. An increase in common stock par of 13% means we must have issued shares. Retained earnings. Okay, now retained earnings went down. Okay, so my retained earnings decreased. So this is going to look a little bit different. So, but we're going to use the same thing. This is negative 15,000, or this is 155 minus 170. So over here, I'm going to show negative 15 divided by 170. And over here, this is going to be a decrease in retained earnings of 8.82%. So that is going through and doing a horizontal analysis. Remember, it's just like you're going to go back to sleep. You're lying down, it's horizontal. If I'm standing up, it is vertical. So let me just take a quick pause. Okay, let's go to the next one over here. So next one over here is exercise 13.4. What this is asking us to do is to show us a vertical analysis. Another way of saying this is calling this a common-sized financial statement. So when I go over here and I'm performing a vertical analysis, and if I'm dealing with the income statement, I show everything as a percentage of total sales, right? So what I'm going to do over here is I'm going to take 800,000, divide it by the same amount, and we'll just do this over here. Okay, and I'll show this as a percentage. Okay, so net sales, this is going to be 800 divided by 800. That's where we're getting the number from. Over here, this is 520 divided by 800. Selling expenses, this is 120 divided by 800. Administrative expenses, this is 60 divided by 800. Income tax expense, this is going to be 30 divided by 800. And then over here for net income, this is going to be 70 divided by 800. For 2024, and this is, by the way, it's very important. This is actually doing common size financial statements or doing a vertical analysis is very important. Remember, with the income statement, you're going to divide everything by total sales. So over here, we're dividing this now by total sales. If you don't know how important Excel is, I don't know how to help you. Make sure you take that class. Okay, so over here, this is my net sales, or 600 divided by 600. This is 408 divided by 600. Again, I'm dividing everything by total sales on the income statement. This is 72 divided by 600. This is 48 divided by 600. This over here is 24 divided by 600. And lastly, we have 48 divided by 600, or 8%. Okay, so the reason why doing these kinds of statements are important for companies is, depending upon the type of business that they're in, we can expect to see certain types of percentages. I'm not going to go through and teach financial statement analysis right now. The purpose of this video is to go through and do different questions, but this is actually a very, very important exercise. Okay, let's now go over to exercise 13.5. This is asking us to go through and prepare a horizontal analysis of the balance sheet data and then a vertical analysis of the balance sheet data. Let's go through first and let's do a vertical analysis. Now, when we are going through and handling our balance sheet, what we want to go through and do for the vertical analysis is, on the income statement, I divided everything by net sales. On the balance sheet, I'm going to be dividing everything by total assets. Some more room. Okay. So I divide everything over here by total assets. This is 9734 divided by 13250. This is 1958 divided by 13250. This is 1558 divided by 13250. And then this is going to be 13250 divided by itself. And as I go over here, again, I'm showing everything as a percentage of total assets, which is also the same as total liabilities plus owner's equity. So this is going to be 3277 by 13250. This is going to be 1280 by 13250. This is going to be 8693 divided by 13250. This is going to be 13250 divided by itself, or at 100%. Over here for 2024, dividing everything by total assets. So coming over here, okay, so this over here, this is going to be 8839 divided by 12443. This is going to be 1891 divided by 12443. This is going to be 1713 divided by total assets, which is 12443. And then over here we get 12443 divided by itself. Okay. This is going to be 3322 divided by 12443. This is going to be 1296 divided by 12443. This is going to be 7825 divided by 12443, and right over here. And that's how we go through and do a vertical analysis, also known as basically all also known as preparing a common sized financial statement. Okay, so now we've gotten to that. Now we're asked to do a horizontal analysis. For the horizontal analysis, I'm trying to go through over here and look at my change, right? When I'm doing the horizontal analysis, it's asking us to use 2024 as the amount of the base year. So over here, I'm taking my current year, which is 2025, subtracting over here the base year, which is 895. So to do the same thing over here, so I've gone over here now and I basically have done this is my change. When I do a horizontal analysis, I not only need to figure out the amount of the change, but I also need to figure out the percentage increase or decrease. The way I'm going to do that is I'm going to take the amount of the change and divide it by the base year. This is going to be at 10%, 3.54 minus 9.05. And as you can kind of go down through here and see it, I just did this kind of elongated for the last one, but we'll go ahead and do this again. This is going to be 895 divided by 8839. This is going to be 67 divided by 1891. This is going to be negative 155 divided by 1713. This is going to be 807 divided by 12443. Over here, you've got negative 45 divided by 3322. You've got negative 16 divided by 1296. You've got over here negative 868 divided by 7825, or excuse me, 868 divided by 7825. And then over here, you've got 807 divided by 12443. So again, the way I would write this is this would be a 3.54% increase in property, plants, and equipment. This over here would be a decrease of 9.05% in total and other assets. On the liability side, you would basically say a decrease of 1.35% in current liabilities, and so go on and so forth. So that's a real basic introduction just to some financial statement exercises. This is a very difficult subject to teach, and it's just because it's very, very subjective. My thoughts on it are with you is just like the best thing you can do with this type of material is just to go through and practice it. If you're taking my class, we'll go through and do some ratios momentarily. But the reason why I don't necessarily like this type of exercise is because when you look at a company, I generally don't have my students do horizontal analysis until like a later chapter. But this part is extremely important in terms of doing the common size financials, or what we call a vertical analysis. And why it's so important is it's going to tell me where I want to focus when I'm going through and doing my ratios. So in any event, I hope you enjoy this video and hope you're having a great 2023 so far. I look forward to seeing you on the next video. And before I say goodbye, I want to say thank you to Wiley for allowing me to use their content in the form of their questions. Have a great day, and I look forward to seeing you on the next video. Have a good one.